So here we have another isosceles triangle. You can see the two legs are shown in red. We have the base shown in blue. The base angles are shown, the vertex is shown, and we have a theorem about isosceles triangles. And that theorem says, if we have two sides of a triangle congruent, in other words, if we have an isosceles triangle, then that isosceles triangle has congruent base angles. So that means that these angles will always be congruent to each other. So, in other words, if you have an isosceles triangle, then the base angles are always going to be congruent. Let me pull that up for you. So we can use that to solve some problems. Let's work on before we work on that example, one thing about this theorem is its converse is also true. Remember, the converse of an if-then statement takes the hypothesis and changes it around with the conclusion. So the original theorem was if two sides are congruent, then the base angles are congruent. The converse would be if the base angles are congruent, then the sides are congruent. In other words, if the base angles are congruent, then we know we have an isosceles triangle. So the biconditional says two sides are congruent if and only if the two angles are congruent. So let's use that to solve some problems here. Here I have an isosceles triangle. The reason I know it's isosceles is there are these congruence marks on the legs. So remember, isosceles triangles, if the legs are congruent, then the base angles are congruent. So here's the base of the isosceles triangle. So that means these are the base angles, and those are congruent. In other words, x and y are equal. Now, using the triangle sum theorem, all three of these angles need to add up to 180, which means x and y together, 180 minus 120 is 60 degrees. And so angles x and y have to share 60 degrees equally. So x and y are the same. If we divide 60 by 2, then we get 30 degrees. So each angle x and y is equal to 30 degrees. Let's take a look at another example. Here I've got, I know I have a right triangle, but I don't have any congruence markings to indicate that it's isosceles. However, since both of these angles say x degrees, that means those two angles must be congruent. And just like we saw in the previous slide, if the angles are congruent, then the sides opposite them are congruent. In other words, if the base angles are congruent, then I know I have an isosceles triangle. So that means these two legs are congruent. Well, those congruence marks show me that y must also equal 3. Now, how are we going to find the red angles? Well, we'll do it in kind of a similar way that we did in the previous problem. Since both of those angles must be congruent, and this angle is 90 degrees, the rest of the two angles must share 180 minus 90. And so both of those angles, that angle and that angle, are 45 degrees. Again, because of the triangle sum theorem and also the theorem about angles in isosceles triangles, we know we can just subtract from 180 and divide by 2.